And welcome back to the Podcast Digest. This is the first double-digit episode. It's episode 10, Pocket Criminal. Well, thank you very much for listening, all of you. My name is Dan Lizette, and thank you again for taking just a few minutes of your week each week to join me here to talk about some great podcast shows, some shows that I think that you should be subscribing to, hopefully some new ones maybe you haven't heard of before, and you are the reason that this show continues to grow. Really, in the last couple of weeks, the Podcast Digest has truly taken off, and it's you I have to thank for it. Telling your friends on Twitter, on Facebook, on Tumblr, whatever your social media outlet of choice is, it's you that are helping this show reach the new levels it's seen here in the last couple of weeks. But if it is your first time here, a big welcome and thank you as well. The Podcast Digest is the weekly show discussing podcast listening related topics and recommending two new shows each week to add to your subscription list with my personal guarantee of greatness behind each one of these shows. I've recently been receiving some awesome feedback of the show, the format, the show recommendations, and it really means a lot to me. In the last episode, episode 9, I talked about possibly fiddling a little bit with the format, maybe doing a special type episode for episode 10. The folks I heard from were like, no, keep it going. Keep the format that you've got. We're really enjoying it. And that was great to hear. So if you do like what you hear, a review or rating on iTunes or Stitcher would really be appreciated. A recommendation in the Overcast application, sharing the link to the episode in Pocket Cast, whatever podcast catcher or player you use. Just let everyone know to join us over here on the Podcast Digest. It would really help make my day. And I'd love to bring in some new listeners and to also hear their suggestions and ideas about what some of the best podcasts out there are. Moving on to our listener pro tip, this section for our 10th episode, I'm going to tweak it just a little bit and sort of call this a Podcast Digest pro tip. Not really generic in the sense of listening to all podcasts, but I want to talk a little bit about this show in and of itself as we look forward to future growth, future listenership continuing to expand. As I've reached this milestone of the 10th episode, I've had some thoughts, as I mentioned, about tweaking and expanding the format and as more and more people are coming aboard. And there is one component of what we're going to do moving forward I did want to address. I've been receiving a lot of suggestions and recommendations via email at thepodcastdigest@gmail.com, on the website, thepodcastdigest.info, and of course at Twitter at Pod Digest. And they've been great. Keep it coming. I would love to know about shows that I've not otherwise discovered through the top charts in iTunes or Pocket Cast or through other submissions. Let me know what shows out there are great. If you're a podcast producer, a host, and you would like me to take a look at your show, let me know. Follow me at Pod Digest on Twitter is probably the easiest and quickest way. Let me be clear about a few things, because there are now probably literally dozens of shows who have reached out to me and asked, hey, you're going to take a look at my show? We'd love to have a review, take a listen, so on and so forth. I want to be clear about a couple of things. I never intended the Podcast Digest to necessarily be an objective perspective on all things podcasting. To be quite frank, I don't think you can do that. Last I heard, there was over a quarter of a million different shows live in iTunes, and it's literally impossible for someone to be able to sample all of those shows, all the episodes, and to fully recommend what the best is out there, for a couple of reasons. One, the breadth of all the shows that are out there, and two, the best is subjective. It is interpretive. What you may think is the best is not something I might think is the best. So when you subscribe or listen here in the Podcast Digest, you are getting my opinion. You are getting my perspective. I hope that's one that syncs up with what you like, but maybe it doesn't, and that's okay. There are really different tastes and different interests, and I've mentioned before that I have talked about trying to expand my horizons, and I do plan on doing that. If you've listened to some of the previous episodes, I've talked about this particular time of year has been extraordinarily busy for me. It continues to be for the next week or so, but then it will let up a little bit and allow me to explore some other genres that I'm not quite as familiar with, and I do plan on bringing some new style of recommendations and some of the ones I've done previously. But I've received so many emails and direct messages on Twitters, sometimes from the show creators, sometimes from the fans of the show, and as I said, I want those to keep coming. But I do want to say, just because you've sent me an email or direct message, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to be reviewed here on the Podcast Digest. I really want the show to represent my true favorites and shows that I really can fully get behind. I want to think that that's what you, the listener, expects. I think that if I'm going to tell you about a show, I think your expectation is that I truly believe in it, and I want you to trust that what I'm telling you is something that you're going to enjoy, because I do want you to go check out all these shows that I've talked about in previous episodes and that I'm going to talk about here for this week as well. That says, that also means that there's going to be shows that, quite frankly, I don't like. They don't strike a tune with me. They are not up my alley. And that's okay. As I said, there are a lot of different tastes. There are a lot of different interests. So if you've sent me an inquiry and asking if I would review your show and you don't hear it, it could mean simply that I've got a long queue. And that's very true. There are a number of things already queued up in my player right now, things I want to check out. I'm already, you know, planning out into episode 11, 12, 13, and trying to get familiar with some of these shows before I talk about them with you. But also, it just may not be something that I like. Maybe it's the content, maybe it's the format, maybe it's the distribution, maybe it's the host, maybe it's the sound quality. For whatever the reason, that is also a possibility that I don't make it a featured episode or featured podcast here on the podcast. So if you've submitted, please keep waiting patiently. If you'd like to give me a shout and I can kind of give you an idea if I plan on reviewing it or maybe not. But just to be clear, there is a certain kind of show that I want to tell everybody straight out, you're just not going to hear me review it. There's been some shows, hosts reaching out to me, asking me to take a look at their show. And I've done it in a couple of instances. And it's just of no interest to me whatsoever. And that is, if you've got an extreme hardcore adult show, your comedy is extraordinarily profane, I'm not going to review it. It's not something I enjoy. It's not up my alley. Now, it's not the language. There's several shows that I've reviewed already that have feature language. Doesn't bother me. It's not even the content. A show that veers into a more adult subject nature. I mean, several of my shows do that already. But if it is a straight hour of frat boy humor or stories about getting drunk or what you did with this girl last weekend, it's not a place I have here on the Podcast Digest for those type of shows. No offense intended. There are a number of people who enjoy that type of comedy and enjoy that type of entertainment. So I want to encourage those producers to keep doing what you're doing. I'm sure that your audience appreciates what you're doing. It's just not something I'm going to end up featuring here on the Podcast Digest. That's it. So I just want to be clear on that, that if you do have that kind of hardcore adult comedy, it's not something I'm interested in reviewing. So let's move on. That is my pro tip section for this week. Sorry for the long diatribe, but I've been getting more and more and more suggestions of fans of shows, of podcast creators and hosts. And I just wanted to put that out there, get that on the record, and so that everything is clear moving forward. So let's move on with our first show recommendation this week. Back to one of my favorite fields of technology. I know you've heard a lot of these. As I mentioned, I do plan on broadening my horizons over the coming weeks and months. But for now, there is a technology-based show that I've not yet talked about that I really feel you technology fans need to be listening to. It is called The Pocket Now Weekly. The hosts are Michael Fisher and Stephen Schenck, amongst a regular rotating guest panel. The website is pocketnow.com/tags/podcast. This is a technology website similar to some of the bigger ones I know you've heard of, The Verge and Gadget. So many of these shows do have their own podcasts. Pocket Now seems to be somewhat a smaller operation than those, but I'm not sure that the podcast gets the attention that it deserves, because I really think it is even better than those big boy shows from the big websites. And there's a lot of sites that I look at, though, the big ones that I mentioned, but I do love Pocket Now. They focus strictly on mobile technology, which is sort of the angle in technology that I'm the biggest fan of. This show covers all genres, WebOS, there you go, Windows Phone, Android, and iOS tablet and phone primarily is what you're going to hear discussed. If you are a fan of these things, you need to be checking out the Pocket Now Weekly. As of this recording, they are 119 episodes in, and they consistently release each and every week, clocking in between 90 and 120 minutes. It is that panel-style show. There's a video version along available with the podcast that's done on YouTube, and they also release a little bit later after the initial release a high-quality audio version on the website. As I mentioned, Michael Fitcher is the main host. I think he does a great job. He's very well versed in mobile technology. He does amazing device reviews. If you go to Pocket Now's YouTube channel, I literally search out Michael's reviews as one of the best available anywhere. And I really think you would enjoy those on YouTube. I always make sure I am watching those as soon as he releases a new video. And he brings this type of knowledge really to the podcast. Recently, he's been joined regularly by the news editor at Pocket Now. That's Stephen Schenck. Stephen Schenck is you can reach out to him on Twitter at Stephen Schenck. That last name is spelled S-C-H-E-N-C-K. And Michael Fisher, the host I mentioned, he's also available on Twitter at Captain2Phones. These two gentlemen commonly bring on other staff from Pocket Now, people like Jaime Rivera, people like Taylor Martin, who's actually in the process of departing, Joe Levi, and their editor-in-chief, Anton Dinoge. They're all great guests. They also bring on guests from other folks in the YouTube world and from other tech websites. Always have a great hour and a half to 2 hour discussion on the week's news in mobile technology. The show's recently gone with that explicit tag, speaking of language, but the language is somewhat rare and very limited in this podcast. It really is what I would call a complete package situation. The panel featuring Michael and Stephen and the guests, the site, the YouTube video reviews that Pocket Now puts on. They have a daily video show, usually around 5 to 7 minutes with Jaime Rivera. I've always just enjoyed the work that Pocket Now does, whether it be video, the audio podcast, the website itself. These guys are consistently putting out quality content each and every week with their releases. They keep the content, the conversations very dense, even though it's on the longer side. I talked about that in a previous episode about the length of the episodes. Do not let that scare you away. If you are interested in mobile technology like I consider myself, you will definitely like the Pocket Now Weekly. I can fully recommend this podcast and add it into your mix if you're a fan of mobile tech. I promise you, you will not regret it. Let's go to our second show this week I wanted to talk about, and I just stumbled across this one, and I think I've done it at just the right time. From what I can gather, this thing is on the verge of takeoff. It is right now a monthly podcast. In fact, the newest episode just came out today, episode 11. It has been around since the start of this year. The name of the show is Criminal. You can find the show on Twitter at Criminal Show. The host, the main host, there are actually three core people that put this together. The host is Phoebe Judge. She's also on Twitter at Phoebe V Judge. The website for the show is www.thisiscriminal.com. Here's the about section from the show's website that I think kind of succinctly summarizes this whole thing. It's stories of people who've done wrong, been wronged, or gotten caught somewhere in the middle. The show's producers are full-time radio people, but Criminal is what they do when they go home at night. It's a monthly show only ranging 10 to 20 minutes in length, so it's extremely easily consumable. You can add this to your subscription list, and it's not going to bog down that big red badge on your podcast app telling you what is still left unheard. Instead, because it's so infrequent, it will literally feel like event-based listening. You can probably tell from the name of the show, Criminal, it's about true crime. The stories are all true, so if you love crime shows, true crime dramas, are really just kind of marveling at the human condition, if you will. Criminal is a show you should check out. If you're a book reader and you like mysteries, things like that, this is very easy to get into. As I said, I only recently discovered this show, and I literally chewed through the first 11 episodes straight. I should say it was the first 10, just like I said, within the last week discovered this, and then episode 11 came out today. It has amazing sound quality. It's extraordinarily very well produced. It's got sound background. The radio, resume of these folks really shows through. The main contributors I mentioned are the host, Phoebe Judge, Eric Manel, and Laura Spohr. They really do an amazing job with this. Unlike many shows, I really want to spotlight the very first episode of this that truly just got me hooked. Now, this isn't just regular telling of crime stories, but rather crime stories that have a unique twist to them. They kind of pick a different angle with each tale that they're relaying to the listeners. It can be an angle from the victim, family members, even the criminal themselves. It's sort of interview style, but it's told through the people who were actually there. You know, some of these people were affected by some horrible situations, and it's wildly intriguing and interesting to hear what this is like. I'd place this podcast something in a similar true storytelling vein as This American Life, which I know everyone knows, which, by the way, is why I've not reviewed it here. But it's also similar to a couple of shows that I have previously recommended. Snap Judgment, I talked about in episode 7. Go back and listen to episode 7 if you'd like to know more about that awesome show. Or Serial, another fairly new show that, by the way, just came out with another new episode today. But I recommended Serial in my episode 6. But it's also unique from This American Life, Snap Judgment, or Serial because of its release schedule. As I mentioned, it's only monthly at this point, and its length, 10 to 20 minutes. This is almost like a no-commitment type thing to add this on. But you will really enjoy even catching up through the back catalog right now. One thing I did want to highlight about this podcast, as these last few episodes I've been listening to, they are in the process of being taken in by Radiotopia. If you've not been made familiar with Radiotopia yet, go to radiotopia.fm. They're in the process of a Kickstarter. They are actually trying to raise some money to bring on Criminal formally, along with two other shows. Radiotopia is 99% Invisible's home, and a couple other shows that you may hear me talk about here in the future on the Podcast Digest. Check them out for more great shows to listen to. If you really enjoy audio stories, dramas, really interesting tales, and that's sort of an area that I've really been taking a lot of my podcast listening to here lately, and I've thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyed it. Anyways, those are my two show recommendations this week on the Podcast Digest. What do you think? What do you think? Check it out. The Pocket Now Weekly and Criminal. And I guarantee you adding those two subscriptions will make your podcast listening all that much more enjoyable. So next week, episode 11, I plan on bringing you two more great show recommendations. Here shortly, I'm going to be probably switching up my release schedule again, probably back to Sundays as it was when I started. I'm not exactly sure if I'm going to switch that this week, but it'll probably be next week. So probably mid-next week, again, look for episode 11 to arrive in your queue. Until then, let me know what you think. Check out the website. Leave a comment on this blog when this post goes live, thepodcastdigest.info. Shoot me an email. Any other show recommendations, anything like that, that is thepodcastdigest@gmail.com. Or follow me on Twitter, probably the most active communication source that I do. That is @poddigest. That's it for me this week, guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you for listening. A review on iTunes or Stitcher is the best way to show me you're there and listening. It's the best way for the show to get discovered and move on and up in the podcast rankings and find more listeners to come share in this conversation about the best shows on the web. Thanks again, guys. My name is Dan Lizette, and I will see you next time.